What's up guys, how are you? So this video, let's quickly see how you can fix an issue that happens when you create a new React Native project, and then when you try to launch it on an Android emulator or basically build your project, you get this error. So this video we'll see how to fix that error. This usually happens with new projects, so I'm getting this issue from some time, and this video I'll show you how to fix that issue. First of all, let's create a new React Native project. So this is my Visual Studio setup, and I'll just run the npx command to create a new React Native project. So this should bootstrap a new React Native project. Let's wait for it to finish up. Usually takes around 2 to 3 minutes. Alright, so as you can see, the project has been created, and these are the basic instructions that is usually shown after the command line utility is over. So here's my project, and it has all the necessary things that it needs for the React Native project. So this is the app.js and this is the index.js file. Now let's try to run this on an Android emulator. Alright, so now let's go into the project and then start our local server so that we can go ahead and launch the project in an Android emulator. So I'm going inside the project, and then let's start the Metro Bundler. Alright, so my package is ready. Now let's open up another panel where I can start or launch the project on an Android emulator. So for that, I'll just say npx react native. React Native run Android. So this should build my project, and then it should launch on my emulator. But usually, as I said at the start of the video, with new projects I'm usually getting this error, but for the first time I get a build error. So you can see here that the project failed to build, and it didn't actually install the app on the emulator. So you can see nothing launched here. So let's see how to fix this. So for that, let me open this project on inside Android Studio first. So I'll open up in my Finder, and okay, so I have the Android folder here. Let's go ahead and say file open. So this is Android Studio, file open, and let me go inside my project. Okay, and here, so I just select the Android folder and say open. Okay, I want to open in the current window, and so it started the gradual build. Let it finish, and then I'll just sync with the build, and then I'll clean the project and rebuild my project again. So this should actually fix the issue. Alright, so let's sync the project again, and so you select file and then say sync project with Gradle files. Let it finish. Okay, so it's done now. Now the next step is to go into the build menu item and then say clean project. So I'm cleaning my project. Okay, done. And then I go and say rebuild project. So let it rebuild the whole project again. Alright, so it's done. So my project is rebuilt again. Now let's go back to my terminal and try to launch it on the Android emulator again. So let me clear this and say npx react native run Android. So this should now actually build the project and then launch the APK on the Android emulator. Let's wait for it to finish. Alright, so it says build successful. Now let's go back to my emulator. Alright, so the app is now launching, and it is actually doing the packaging. So it is converting the JavaScript into the native files using the Metro Bundler. So as you can see, the bundling is happening here, and that's the percentage of completion. It takes a little while for the first time. There we go. So now the React Native application is actually open on the Android emulator. So we have successfully actually built the project and launched the app on the Android emulator. So this is usually, as I said, is a problem with Android. I haven't faced this issue with iOS. And these are the steps to fix it. Alright, good luck. Have a good day.